Hi, my name is Melissa, and I'm here at the Rain Training Center in Orange County with KJM. And as you can see, some of the KJM guys are already out here, and they're planning out how they're going to best film this event. What it is that they're going to have an MMA fight here tonight. And not only that, but KJM actually got a brand new switcher to work with, thanks to the good folks at Data Video. And we're going to test it out tonight.
I'm going to put them here. They have a little table, and they're going to have the cameras. They're going to run these cords here, and the cameras over there.
I mean, if we're here, are we in the way of them?
No, I don't think anyone's going to be here. This side is a good side to shoot from. This side and that side, in front of the lights.
We're rigging a camera mount. We need to be what's called a bird's eye view. So we want to be able to take a camera that's going to be just isolated and static. That'll show pretty much the whole ring. So we just come up with a regular camera head, attached it to a C-stand head to a high roller. And we're going to raise it up and see what kind of view we get. So.
This is our fifth event. We're about to do Quake in the Cage. Hi, I'm Frank. I'm the coordinator for ringoffiremma.com and here with Vince, the promoter.
The big difference about tonight is usually we do a stationary camera and maybe one roaming camera, and then we go back and Frank has to edit everything together and try and make it look, you know, as professional as possible. What we're excited about tonight is that we have KJM here and we have a live switcher here, so we have multiple cameras feeding it, and I think it's going to be pretty good for the show.
You were using a new switcher today. Tell me about it. I know it's brand new. You just got it.
We just got it a few days ago and just got our heads wrapped around it. The biggest thing is that it's so portable. We've used other switchers that require a lot more manpower to kind of move around. It's a little bit bulkier. But this thing, when we went to pick it up from Data Video, it was amazing. It was just in this little briefcase.
And you can still see everything. You're not behind something.
Yeah. I can see the ring. I'll be able to see every camera person. Yeah. So it's a good spot.
When we got here, it was a sensor set up. You just open up the doors, you plug it in, and you're ready to go. We were done way ahead of schedule today.
Hey guys, I'm here with Mark Munoz. He's the owner of Rain MMA Center here.
It's an unbelievable opportunity for me to just showcase the gym. And I feel that with young fighters coming in, it gives them the opportunity to kind of get their feet wet. That's an experience I never had.
I'm feeling really good. You know, I made weight. You know, I feel strong, I feel fit, I feel fast. Here to put on a good show, defend my title, that's all that matters.
Ready to go, 5 minutes to showtime.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight is scheduled for 32 minute rounds. This is the 185-pound.
The mental challenge before the actual fight was like the biggest one. Kept psyching myself out because they said this guy was coming off a knockout. So in my mind, it was just like me getting knocked out. I was like, oh man. And once I got in there, it wasn't nearly as bad.
In 2 days, I was basically able to learn something, you know, and put a piece of machinery out here, a piece of equipment that I could, you know, shoot something at television quality. And there was no manual I needed to read. There was no really instructions I really needed. I mean, it was very simple.
Did they just give the belt to him? They robbed me. I won the whole fight, you know, come on. I slammed him. He only got me in the cage and just threw knees at me, that's it.
It was kind of an emotional fight because the guy I fought was a friend of mine, a training partner of mine, and we just happened to be at the top at the same time.
First round, I got a good takedown. Second round, I got like two, three takedowns in the same corner.
Impossible. It's
not fair. I mean, it was a close fight. I mean, he definitely has an argument for it. He's a tough guy. What kind of friend would I be if not to give him a rematch?
I'm here with Steve Whistler, part of KJM staff. Steve, you had the best seat in the house. Tell us about it.
I'm doing the camera right above the ring, so I'm just swooped right down on top of all the action. So my shot's getting used primarily, so it's pretty intense.
In a normal situation, I'd kind of be left out on my own. I wouldn't know, am I hot? Should I be shooting this? Or what the director's kind of wanting of me, especially in this kind of three-camera switcher environment. Everybody's giving different shots, and it's like you don't want to get double shots. I don't want to be getting the same shot as someone else. So being able to have, you know, the headset on, the tally light on, knowing exactly when I'm hot and when I'm not hot, this is just imperative. It may make my job easier, and it may be able to kind of work more proficiently.
Congratulations, you won an MMA fight. How do you feel?
I feel great. I feel like I won $1 million from going to Disneyland.
It was amazing watching you. What are your plans for the future?
Well, actually, this is my, I won't tell the organization this, but this is my last amateur fight. I'm not even defending this. I'm giving it back real soon here, and I'm going pro.
I've shot a lot of different things, and
as far as I'm concerned, it's probably the most fun I've ever had. You know, we shot it with this, which is the HS2000. By looking at least at the quality, I haven't gotten it back and take a look at what it looks like, but at least on here, I mean, that looked like, you know, professional TV quality. It looked like something that could have went on pay-per-view. And here we are on a table, right here in the middle of it.
You had great takedowns, you had great control on the top. He was just strong and bucked you up. You never disappoint.
I was able to be in the environment, which is insane. I'm able to feel the energy, and I mean, this place was rattling during the event.
I thought it worked pretty smoothly, and I was going back there and I was watching the footage, and it looked really clean.
I could see him switching, the guy working the panel, and the guys over there working the cameras. I'm real excited to see how it comes out.
So it's been a long day. Time to wrap it up. As you can see, all the chairs and stuff are down, so I'm gonna end this now and go clean up.
That's a wrap, guys. Let's load up and head home.